गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टू कंटिन्यू विद द प्रीवियस क्लास आई विल स्टार्ट टुडे विद द आर्टिकल्स विच आर रिक्वायर्ड फॉर डूइंग ए फिजिकल एग्जामिनेशन. इन द प्रीवियस क्लास आई हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द हिस्ट्री टेकिंग टेक्निक, द कॉम्पोनेंट्स ऑफ हिस्ट्री विच इंक्लूडेड प्रेजेंट हिस्ट्री, पास्ट हिस्ट्री, फैमिली हिस्ट्री, न्यूट्रिशनल हिस्ट्री, सोशो इकोनॉमिक स्टेटस, एनवायरमेंटल हिस्ट्री, एवरीथिंग. नाउ द नेक्स्ट स्टेप ऑफ हेल्थ असेसमेंट इज फिजिकल एग्जामिनेशन. फॉर दैट वी रिक्वायर सर्टेन आर्टिकल्स. लेट अस सी द आर्टिकल्स. वन इज बीपी इंस्ट्रूमेंट. पर्पस इज टू मेजर द बीपी. स्टेथोस्कोप इज यूज फॉर ऑस्कल्टेशन, to listen the body sounds. That means especially it is used for the examining the heart sounds and lung sounds and the bowel sounds. For this stethoscope is required. The next TPR tray. TPR is temperature pulse respiration. That means in that you have to keep the thermometers to measure the temperature, pulse and respiration, vital signs of a patient. The next is tongue depressor. Tongue depressor is used to visualize the oral cavity. Next is pharyngeal retractor. It is used for visualizing the pharynx. Retractor is a type of instrument which is used to visualize, which helps to visualize a particular body part. Then tape measure. This is used for the examination of, to measure the skull circumference, abdominal circumference, mid-arm circumference. Then next is flashlight or torch is also required. Weighing machine to take the weight of the patient. Ophthalmoscope, otoscope, these are also used to see the retina. Otoscope is used to see the, examine the ear till the eardrum. Snellen's chart, it is used for examining the vision. Then color blindness, chart for color blindness. Then tuning fork is also required. Nasal speculum, then percussion hammer, vaginal speculum or sim speculum. Proctoscope is a type of instrument used to examine the rectum. Then gloves is sometimes required. Then sterile specimen bottle if you want to collect specimen during the examination for further diagnosis. Cotton applicators, these are used for the sensation of touch. The detail and the pictures of the physical examination I will show in the next class. Then next, how to proceed for the physical examination. When we are doing examination in a simplified manner, you should remember that first we have to do a general survey or general appearance. In that, general appearance includes what is the you have to see the general appearance of the person, behavior of the person, age of the person. General appearance includes signs of distress, whether patient is having pain. By seeing a patient, you can easily find out that whether the patient is in pain, has difficulty in breathing, is anxious, and then you can find out nourishment. Overall nourishment means whether the body build is thin, muscular or obese. Then posture of the patient. This is the general appearance. It is included in the general appearance only. Posture is straight or bent. Lordosis, kyphosis, scoliosis, these are some abnormal curvatures of spine. Then gait means the walking, the way the person walks into the room. It is coordinated or uncoordinated. Uncoordinated can be due to some disease or due to some intoxication like alcohol, etc. Then body movements, whether it is purposeful or the person is having tremors which are not purposeful or which are not under control of that particular patient, or any part is immobile, any musculoskeletal injury or problem is there or not. So this is the general appearance and behavior. In the general appearance and behavior, further we can find out hygiene and grooming by seeing the condition of hair, skin, fingernail, clothes. Then the dress, it will reflect the culture of a patient, lifestyle, even socioeconomic status to sometimes even personal preference. Then body odor, smell, the bad odor, it is due to excessive sweating, which can be due to exercise or poor hygiene, or a person is very hard worker laborers. Observe for fruity odor is seen in diabetes, ketoacidosis. Then odor of alcohol, etc. Then what is the mood of a person? Is it appropriate or not? It is appropriate to the situation or not? Whether he is very anxious, worried, depressed. Then the speech of the patient, the tone, the pace, association of the with the thoughts, whether these are it is coherent with the thoughts or not. Then next is consciousness, whether patient is fully conscious, unconscious, delirious, or talking incoherently. So this is general appearance and behavior. After that, we will take height and weight of a person. This is the next step, general appearance and behavior ke baad, height and weight. After that, we have to take the vital signs of a patient, which include temperature, pulse, respiration, and BP. Then we will see, this is also a part of inspection, skin condition. Start with the first, with the skin. Skin condition, in that you have to see the color of the skin, the pallor. Pallor means pale skin. Jaundice is yellowish skin. Cyanosis is bluish tinge of the skin. Flushing, it is redness, redness of the skin. It is due to disease or vasodilatation. Tanning is present or not. Then texture, whether it is very dry, the flaking is there, wrinkling, or excessive moisture. It is excessively moist. Skin is excessive moist or not. Then the temperature of the skin, whether it is warm or cold and clammy. Then you have to see the visible lesions. If the patient is saying that he is having some skin disorder, then only we will examine the type of lesions. Lesions include macule, papule, vesicle, wound, any type of wound, etc. Then turgor. Turgor is the elasticity. And turgor is normally increase in edema, decrease in dehydration. Edema is present or not. These are the points which have to be remembered when you are writing the condition related to the skin. Skin conditions, and so color, texture, temperature, lesions. This is important. Then related to the skin assessment history, any history of skin color change, you have to ask how much time is spent outside, sunscreens are used, frequency of bathing, type of soap used, any allergies are there, family history of any serious skin disorder like psoriasis, skin cancer is present or not. So this is all related to the skin. These are some of the skin lesions. One is macule, next is papule, next is nodule. These are all given in any medical surgical nursing books. Then skin tumor, then plaque, dental plaque is also seen, and here the plaque on the skin is also seen. Especially it is seen in chronic dermatitis. By repeated itching, the skin will look like this plaque. Then vesicle. Vesicles are generally seen in some viral disease, chickenpox, herpes. This is vesicle. Then pustule. That vesicle, when it is filled with pus or leukocytes, this is pustules. then wheel. Wheel is like mosquito bites. Large wheels are also there. This is generally due to allergies. The crust, dried exudate of body fluids, blood, serous fluid, which might be either yellow or red crust. This is crust. Ulcer formation. Ulcer is an area of the skin from which the whole of the epidermis and at least the upper part of the dermis has been lost. Normally, ulcer always bleeds and it will cause scarring. Then, in the skin only, I have said that we have to examine for edema. Now, whether it is pitting edema or non-pitting edema. So it was related to the skin conditions. Next step will be condition related to hair and scalp. In that, cleanliness, condition of the hair, texture, dandruff, hair loss is there, pediculosis is there or not, ringworm infection of the scalp, hair distribution in male and females. Because it will also show the general, the health of a patient. It is also an important sign to examine the hair and the scalp. Then nails. Nails reflect individual's general state of health, the nutrition status and the occupation of a person. Abnormalities are polyonychia. This is due to iron deficiency, anemia, clubbing. It is seen in respiratory disease, chronic bronchitis, etc. Then transverse depression in nails are also there. Then next examination will be related to head and neck. Earlier we have to write about the examination related to hair, scalp, nails, etc. Now detailed examination of head and neck. And head, shape of the skull and fontanelles, especially for newborn, small children we are doing, otherwise in adults it is not required. Then face, we have to see the face of the patient, whether it is pale, flushed, puffiness, fatigue, pain, fear, anxiety, everything is written on the face actually. So you can find these all findings. Then next is eye. In eyes, we have to first see the external structures. External structures with eyes examination, we have to write eyebrows. These are present or not. Symmetry absent or normal. Ability to move eyebrows or not. Then eyelashes, whether they are infected or not. Sty is there. Eyelids, then we have to see the eyelids. Whether the eyelids are puffy, that means edema is there or not. Any ectropion or entropion, eversion of eyelid, entropion is inversion of eyelid, ptosis of eyelid, the drooping of eyelid is present or not. Then eyeballs, sunken or protruded. In some disease, like thyroid, hyperthyroidism, sometimes the eyeballs are very much protruded. Then conjunctiva and sclera, you have to see the color of the conjunctiva and sclera. Normally it is white, otherwise if it is very pale, anemia, red, some bleed, it is due to bleeding of the vessels. Then purulent, due to some infection. Sclera, the color is yellow. If it is yellow, then you can say the person is having jaundice. Then cornea. Then next is, in the examination of eye, we have to see the cornea. There are irregularities and aberrations with oblique lighting. We use a light source with the help of a torch, and directly in front of the face, do not blink the light. Oblique lighting means stand to the side of the patient and then you use the torch light. Then only you will be able to see the cornea. We have to inspect each eye for opacities and note any opacities in the lens. After that, pupil and iris, these you have to see whether it is normal reaction to light. When light is focused to the pupils, it will contract, otherwise it will again dilate. dilated or constricted. Then next is lens. These are opaque or transparent. You can ask to the patient, and old person will have the lens will gradually become opaque because of cataract. Then the fundus. This is examined with the help of ophthalmoscope. The congestion, hemorrhagic spots are present or not. Then eye muscles, strabismus, that means person is having squint, nystagmus or ptosis. Then next is coordination of eye movement. This is an important function, neurological function of the eye, that the movement of the eye should be coordinated. How you will do? Hold the object at a distance, any object at a very distance, like a pen, at a distance from the client. Ask him or her to keep his or her head still and follow the object with the eyes. Move the object towards his right and left eye, then towards the ceiling and floor. Repeat to the other side. So both eyes are examined like this. The coordination of eye movements must be present. If it is not there, then some disorders are there and further examination is required. Then convergence test. This is also a type of eye test only, muscle test. It is the test for the eye muscles only. Ask the client to follow your finger or a pencil as you move in towards the bridge of the nose. The converging eye normally follows the object to within 5 cm to 8 cm of the eyes. So by this, then next is we have to see the vision of a patient, whether he is hypermetropic, myopic or normal. Then color vision test, red and green color blindness. Normally it is checked with the help of a color blindness chart. So this was all about eye examination. So conjunctivitis is like this. The conjunctiva is very reddish, it is totally red in color. Strabismus is squint or bhangapan. Then next up we have to examine the ear. Ear में आप क्या लिखोगे? फर्स्ट वी हैव टू राइट अबाउट द एक्सटर्नल ईयर, और उसके बाद फिर आपको इंटरनल ईयर. इंटरनल ईयर मतलब यू हैव टू आस्क द पेशेंट अबाउट हियरिंग, कि सुनाई ठीक से दे रहा है या नहीं दे रहा है. तो एक्सटर्नल ईयर्स में क्या है? सी द डिस्चार्जेस और सेरुमेन इफ इट इज ऑब्स्ट्रक्टिंग द ईयर पैसेज, टिम्पैनिक मेम्ब्रेन, परफोरेशन इज देयर और नॉट. नॉर्मली दिज आर नॉट डन, दिज आर डन बाय द ईएनटी एक्सपर्ट. एंड हियरिंग एक्यूटी, these are two tests which are done with the help of tuning fork. One is Weber test, one is Rini test, the comparison of ear and bone conduction. So with the help of this these two tests, with the help of the tuning fork, we'll be able to distinguish whether the person has conduction hearing loss or sensory hearing loss. So this is about the ear examination. Then next is nose and sinuses. So we have started with the general appearance, then to some extent mental status, then postures, after that height and weight was taken, then skin conditions detail I have said, then head and face. Head we have to measure the circumference and all the shape, etc., the scalp, condition of the scalp, hair, face. After that eye examination, then ear examination, then nose and sinuses examination. In that, inflammation of the mucous membrane, tenderness, swelling, discharge, bleeding, crusts, polyps, examination of sinuses are done. How you are examining the sinuses? You have to press like this. It is seen in the diagram, shown in the diagram. Then next, subjective data about oral cavity. In that we have to, so this was all about the sinuses, how you will examine. If you are pressing, when you press like this and patient is saying that he is having or she is having pain, that means the sinuses are inflamed. The patient has infection in the of the sinus, which is seen in common cold or repetitive cold. Then subjective data about oral cavity. In that, now oral, the examination of mouth and pharynx or the oral cavity. In that, we have to see dental hygiene, water intake, alcohol, smoking or chewing tobacco, dysphagia, ulcer, artificial teeth, toothache, altered taste or sore throat is there or not. These are the questions which have to be asked about the when you are doing examination related to mouth and pharynx, the related questions or history you can say. Then what are the, how you will examine mouth and pharynx? Start with the lips, redness, swelling, crust, cyanosis, lesions, lips are very dry or moist. The angle of the mouth has cracks, chelosis. This is due to some vitamin deficiency. Then odor of the mouth, whether he is having foul smell or not. Then gum and conditions of the gum and teeth, plaque, discoloration hai ya nahi teeth, caries are present, dental caries are present or not, artificial teeth are there, edema of the gums, bleeding and swollen gums. Then mucous membrane of the buccal cavity, we have to examine the mucous membrane. In that, see for ulceration, any bleeding. Then color of the mucous membrane, buccal mucosa. Inspect for jaundice, pallor, if it is very pale, anemia. Then leukoplakia, it is a condition which is related to cancer. Then the condition of the tongue, the pale, dry, any lesions, sores, furrows, tongue tie is present or not. Then palate, palate is the hard palate, soft palate, so you have to see the color, texture, extra bony prominences are there or not. Throat and pharynx, enlarged tonsils, redness, pus are present or not. To examine the mouth and pharynx, we can use tongue depressor and then pharyngeal retractor can also be used. Then next is examination of the neck. Oral cavity has been examined. Now next will be the neck examination. Neck, what all things we will ask? Neck pain, ki movement mein koi pain to nahi ho raha. Then you have to ask that whether patient is having any problem related to thyroid or thyroid medication le raha ya nahi le raha. Or koi recent cold infections hai ya nahi. Otherwise that the glands of the neck, they may be swelling. Then lumps are there on the neck, swelling, any surgery mark is there. Then objective data, this is the subjective data, these all things you have to ask. That is subjective data is related to the history. Then objective data for neck, it will be related to the inspection. First is whether the neck is symmetrical or not, the midline is symmetrical, that means the neck is in symmetry or not. Then we have to palpate for the carotid pulsations. Then note any type of enlargement of the lymph node. Then test for the range of motion exercises. Range of motion exercises will determine whether patient has any neck pain or not. So this is about the objective data related to the lymph nodes. How you will examine the, palpate the lymph nodes. Palpate all the nodal areas beginning with the preauricular nodes and ending with the supraclavicular nodes. And check these lymph nodes for any type of tenderness, enlargement, etc. So in the neck, whether the lymph nodes are enlarged or palpable, thyroid gland is enlarged or not, range of motion which I have said, that flexion, extension, rotation, the patient is able to perform all this range of motion or not, trachea is in the midline or not, this will show the symmetry. So this is all about the examination till the neck. I will continue with the next class. Thank you, students.